Hi there, today I'm going to take you through how to get started with Gravity PDF quickly. What you want to do is go to the plugins, add new page from your WordPress admin area. We're going to search for Gravity PDF. Be the first option that appears, it should be, and you can hit the install now button. Gravity PDF is what's known as freemium software, with the core plugin being absolutely free and available from WordPress.org, and paid extensions or templates to unlock additional designs. It's also been around for over 7 years now, and in that time accrued 280 reviews and currently has 40,000 active installations. Once it's installed, you can hit the activate button. And right away, you'll see a prompt up the top asking you to install the core PDF fonts. This is to allow the plugin to display languages from all across the world, including your standard English, Russian, more advanced scripts like Arabic or Hebrew, Japanese and Chinese. Go ahead and click the Install Core Fonts button and it'll take you to the PDF Tools section and run through the installation. You can see a counter on the right here telling you how many fonts is remaining, and down here is a log of the installation and how it's going. We successfully installed all the core fonts. If you had a problem installing any of the fonts, it would tell you which fonts had a problem and ask if you wanted to retry. So click the retry button if that shows up, and it'll try again. Once the core fonts are installed, you can head to your forms page. We're going to go configure a PDF on one of our forms here. I've actually preloaded this site with Gravity Form templates. So Gravity Forms has a form template library on their website, and you can preview and download a bunch of different template designs and then import them on your website. I think we'll configure this on the advanced contact form, the PDF. So hover over it and then, hover over the settings, submenu item, and then go down to the PDF section. From this page, we're going to hit the Add New button, and we'll go ahead and start filling it out. So the PDF requires two fields to be entered when you set this up, the label and the file name. It also needs a template, but because that is a drop-down or select box, one is always available. So I'm going to call this the contact form summary. And for the template, we in the free offering, we have four options. If you want to get a look at what they look like, you can hit the manage button on the right here. And I'll show you previews of the available templates. You can also search templates here if you have a lot installed. If you purchase one of our template passes or all access pass, you install all the available templates we offer, then you might have a lot larger list, and you might use the search feature here to search for one of the templates. To find out a bit more about them, you can hit the template details. They'll give you a bit of an info about what that template is, what it supports, and the current version. And you can scroll through the available options here. Focus Gravity has styling more akin to Gravity Forms print page. But by default, it's designed to mimic that or close to it anyway. Rubik's is another option with a solid background and rounded corners for all the fields. And the Danny, the default with a nice little one pixel border around all the field values. I'm going to stay with Zdeny for this particular demo. And for the file name, put contact summary. And I'm going to select this button on the right here, which is the merge tag selector. And this allows me to include Gravity Forms data in the file name. So I could include the user's name, or I could include the form ID or the entry ID, the date that they've submitted it. There's a whole heap of different options here, and it'll depend on what fields you've got in your form too. This top section, the required fields and optional fields section, will show you the fields that you've got in your form. And then down the bottom, under other, you've got entry metadata, like the IP address, if you have that feature enabled, the submission date, entry ID. There's also additional merge tags or merge tag modifiers that can be used here, but just aren't included in the merge tag selector. For example, if you had a radio field that you wanted to include, but you wanted to display the label instead of the value, you can add the modifier directly into the box, and it will work. Just because it's not in this list doesn't mean you can't use it. So I'll actually go ahead and add the first name, and then we'll add the last name, and we'll hit the add PDF button. That's all you need to generate a PDF. There is additional settings that can be modified. You can adjust the paper size and the font size. You can change how the template is displayed. And this template section will be particular to the template you've picked up in the dropdown. Different templates can support different settings. In Zdeny and all the core templates, you can add a header or footer, background, image, or color. Choose various options related to fields that are displayed or not displayed. And then there's some advanced settings down the bottom. And in another video, I'll go through the different setting options that can be used in more details. But for this video, just the basics is fine. So we'll leave it as just configuring the general section. Once it's saved, we'll go to the entries tab. If you don't have any entries showing yet, you can submit a new entry by going up to the preview button and clicking it, and a new tab will open up, allowing you to fill out the form. Just fill out some content, hit submit, and then refresh this page, and you'll be able to view the PDF for the entry you just submitted. So I've got two entries in my list at the moment. If I hover over it, I can see there's a submenu. And in there, there's a view PDF link. So if I click that, in my browser, will pop up the PDF document that was created with Gravity PDF. And this is going to include the form fields that were entered into the Gravity form, and in my configuration, it includes the form title. And that's a PDF document, so I can download that locally and it'll be saved as a PDF. And we can also do the same for the other entry in the list. And it's going to show me different content to the first PDF we saw, because I entered different information into the form. Now, one of the common setups that people like to do is they want to allow the user to download the PDF right after the form is submitted. So to do that, you go to Settings and PDFs. And on the right here is a shortcode column, and we can click that and hit copy. We can paste this shortcode directly into our confirmation page. So I'm going to go to the confirmation section, edit my default confirmation, This is just the demo confirmation text from the Gravity Forms template library. So I'm going to change that to thanks for getting in touch. You can download a copy of your inquiry below. And I'll paste that shortcode and hit save. And then when I preview my form and I fill it out, and hit submit, I will get a link showing that allow me to download a copy of that PDF. Here's my link. Yes, I want to download that, please. And then here's an example of the submission I just did and the PDF downloaded on my computer. The last option that people like to do that I'm going to cover in this video is attaching the PDF to a notification email. You actually have to have a notification set up. In this demo form is a user notification, which is going to be automatically sent to the email address that is submitted in the form. So I'm going to go back to the PDF settings and edit the one we made. And below the templates option is a notifications option. And this is going to show all the available notifications set up under that notification tab. So I'm going to select the user notification, hit update. And if I resubmit that form and view my emails, I'll be able to download that PDF. So this is the message that's included or sent to the user. And if I go to the attachment section, you can see I've got a PDF called Contact Summary First Last. First Last was the name I used in the name field. And when I download that and view it, that was straight from as an attachment from my email. They're the very common setups for Gravity PDF. There is a whole heap of customizations that can be done with all the things that I've shown you today. And keep an eye out for a follow-up video going through the various settings that you can use.